Welcome to Muscles 1.4, where we'll discuss the femoral region, specifically the anterior thigh, rectus femoris, vastus lateralis, vastus medialis, and the vastus intermedius. Those first four make up the quadriceps femoris muscles, and we'll need to look at attachments for those four. Additionally, we have the sartorius, gracilis, adductor longus, adductor magnus, iliopsoas, tensor, fasciae, lyte, and the iliotibial band. So moving on to our model right here, and I've realized that I can toggle back and forth between a female model and a male model. I didn't realize that in previous videos. I was calling it both male and female. You have to take this somewhat with a grain of salt because these features, more gracile or more robust, do vary significantly from population to population, but we will use the female model on this one, and we're going to focus on the anterior thigh, which is right here. The most superficial of these muscles is the sartorius muscle, which aids in knee and hip flexion. If we hide that muscle, we can look at the four quadriceps muscles, which in no particular order are the vastus medialis, rectus femoris, vastus lateralis, and if I hide the rectus femoris, deep to that is the vastus intermedius. All of these muscles of the quadriceps are inserting on the patella via the patellar tendon. Tendons attach muscle to bone, so we call that the patellar tendon. Down here, we would call that the patellar ligament, which is attaching bone to bone. And the patellar ligament attaches inferiorly to the tibial tuberosity. All of these four quadriceps function to extend the knee. And as far as attachments, like I said, inferiorly, they all attach to the patella. If I isolate the rectus femoris, we can see superiorly it attaches to the anterior inferior iliac spine and the superior aspect of the acetabulum. If we look at the vastus medialis, we can see it going from the medial proximal region of the femur to the patella. Vastus lateralis attaching to the greater trochanter superiorly and inferiorly to the patella. And lastly, if we hide the rectus femoris and focus on the vastus intermedius, we can suggest it's just moving from the anterior and proximal femur to the patella. So those are the quadriceps femoris muscles. If I hide the vastus medialis and hide the sartorius, we can get a better look at some of these muscles. The most medial of these muscles is the gracilis right here. And the gracilis functions to flex the knee and medially rotate the tibia. And I'm going to hide the gracilis. So now we can get a look at this muscle right in here. Excuse me, right here, which is the adductor magnus. Now the adductor magnus is a super broad muscle. If I were to isolate it, that's what it looks like right there. And as the name suggests, it's a major adductor of the thigh, moving the thigh medially. In addition to that, we have the adductor longus, which also moves the thigh medially, adduction. Okay, we're going to reset all of those. Another muscle of the anterior thigh we are going to look at is a combination of these, which we will collectively call these two muscles the iliopsoas. Interiorly, in the pelvic cavity and the abdominal cavity, is where the psoas major comes from, and the iliacus as well. So I'm just going to isolate the iliacus, and we can see it attaching to the iliac crest and iliac fossa of the right innominate bone in this case, and then attaching inferiorly to the femur. If we look at the psoas major, and you don't need to know these attachments, I just think they're pretty amazing where they're attaching to and going to. So the iliopsoas is attaching superiorly to the lateral bodies of lumbar vertebrae, and the superiormost is the T12, but let's just say lateral surface of vertebrae, and then attaching down on the femur. The iliopsoas muscle is a major hip flexor. Next, we're going to point out this muscle right here, which is the tensor fasciae lyte. It extends the knee, rotates the tibia, abducts, and medially rotates the femur. So there's a litany of actions for the tensor fasciae lyte. And inferior to that, we have the iliotibial band or iliotibial tract, a non-muscular structure in this area. That's it for muscles 1.4. I apologize for any of the, I think that's a jackhammer going on next door. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Nonetheless, that's it for 1.4.